Hi everyone, welcome to a yet another engaging session on our farm health. हमारी यही कोशिश है कई सारे हफ्तों से जब से लॉकडाउन चल रहा है कि हम हमारी कंट्री के बड़े एक्सपर्ट्स को जो कि who are like the leaders in their own specialties उन सब को आप तक लेकर आएं. And one of such healthcare experts जो हमारे साथ शुरू से जुड़े हैं and जिनका support हमें रहा है, that is Dr. Pradeep Chaubey. Sir is the director of laparoscopy, endoscopy and bariatric surgery at Max Institute of at Max Super Speciality Hospital, Saket. पिछली बार जब हमने बात करी थी, we had spoken about gallbladder surgery and the complications of gallstones. And उस time पे there was the COVID crisis had slightly reached India. Abhi it had not turned into a pandemic. Even WHO had not called it a pandemic at that time. But sir did mention some important points that people should remember. So sir, thank you so much. आपने time निकाला. And so what is the situation right now? And thanks again for being associated with us. So थोड़ा बताइए COVID की crisis के चलते how are the doctors coping and what is going on?
Okay, so hi everybody, and thank you Dr. Khubsurat for this opportunity. It's always very interesting and very encouraging to discuss this matter. And I must say that COVID infection and the viral infection has really taken the world by storm, and I don't think anything like this has happened maybe almost about 100 years. So I think this is a situation we will always remember, or the generation will always remember. Another point is that since this thing has come in the horizon, lot of at the beginning, I think we hardly knew anything about this virus, because we all know that it's a very new virus which has mutated to infect the human beings. So it's a mutated virus. It's from the COVID family and the corona family. And because it appeared in 2019, we call it as a COVID-19 or corona-19 virus. So that is one thing. But in last couple of weeks, I think the understanding has really changed, advanced. And now we know much more about this virus than what we knew a couple of weeks back. I would like to just summarize for our viewers, and I would like to emphasize that there should be no panic with this virus. It is important to understand what this virus is, what it can do, how it spreads, how you can prevent. And once you follow these things, I still will feel that you should be definitely very confident with you and your family and your friends that it is not going to affect you. I'm starting it on a very optimistic note, because I have seen in these couple of weeks that there is such a serious situation which has come. It is a serious situation, but whatever it is, we have to face it boldly, and we have to face it with understanding. So that is what my submission is. Now, first of all, we must understand that this is a heavy virus with a 2.5 micron size, and that is a great advantage to for spread. Why? Because all these heavy viruses, they fall down because of gravity on the ground. Achoo. So somebody who is suffering from coronavirus, and if he coughs, the virus can go only up to say maybe 3 feet, and if the patient sneezes, then it may go maybe up to 6 feet, but then it falls down, right? So it's not airborne disease. That's, I would say, a big blessing for us and human mankind, because anything which is airborne, I think the whole half of the country would have, our world would have been down with this. So it's a heavy virus, it falls. So I think, you know, while you are coughing or sneezing, if we have some protective gear on the mouth, nose, you will be first not throwing it out of your body. And if somebody is throwing it, you will not be able to inhale it, because it goes through the nasal route, oral route, and through the eyes. So that is the from where it gets entry into the body. So that is one thing about it. Second thing is that we must understand the importance of social distancing. And social distancing, matlab, you should be at least 6 feet away from each other. That means that even if the person, I think, and also it's a good idea to presume that the person whom you are talking is infested with this
virus.
Yeah, because there is many situations, almost 25% person will be spreading this virus without having any symptoms at all. And this is the suggested, but you know, some studies are saying that even in 50% patients, the person may not have any fever or symptoms and may be positive for a virus and still may be transmitting it. So that is what I think, again, a change in our understanding which has taken place. So that is one important thing. So what happens that if you cover your mouth with a face mask, now I think this has also changed over a period of time. Today we are saying that ordinary homemade face mask, I'm sure there's so many videos which are available. You can, we all can make dozens of face masks according to your dress which you are wearing, the color which you want, and you can wash it as many times as you can. And so that is a good thing. So we all must, the moment you step out, first of all, social distancing. So you should not step out of your home because you don't know who is going to pass by you, who's going, may come close to you, maybe accidentally comes close or in a queue or in any place. So that can reduce that distance and you can get infected. That is one point. So we should assume that you are suffering from coronavirus and other is also suffering. So there should be 100% precautions which has to be taken. So first of all, your moving out of home should be absolutely minimal, only for procuring your groceries or some urgent sort of, you know, medications and things like that. Otherwise, you can always ask it for online. So that is one. Second, whenever you are moving, first of all, you move out, wash your hand first before going out, wear the mask, and wherever you go, keep a distance of at least 6-7 feet from the next person who is standing in a queue. Keep that distance, maintain that distance all around you, not only in front, but only on the side as well as on the back. And whatever you buy, whatever this thing, suppose you buy some medicine and there is a cover. So what you do is when you come back home, take off your mask, take off that external, say envelope, put it in a dustbin or destroy it, wash your hands, and that's all. So these are the small little things. I insist more washing rather than relying much on sanitizers. Sanitizers should be used only when washing is not available. So when you are at home, I think you can wash your hands 100 times, you know, without any problem. Because it not only kills the virus, but it also washes off the virus from your hand. So, and you should do it frequently. You may be touching the surfaces, you may be touching table, you may be touching doors, knobs. So it is always better that consider whatever you are touching is infected.
Yeah.
So overcautious is going to really prevent, because if even one family member is down with it, the whole family will suffer. All the friends whom you have come in contact in last 2-3 weeks will also suffer. And according to the law, you may be put in some hospital, which is not a very at all desirable. And all the family will go for quarantine. So everybody will suffer. Second thing, which I would say, is that a lot of people are being a little lazy. They continue having their help from outside. You know,
yes.
That is a big trap. I think you should do everything yourself. Maybe whatever best you can do. Because anybody coming from outside,
we have no control over it.
You have no control whom that guy is meeting, whom, from where he got that infection, and he may be asymptomatic. So please 100% avoid anybody, part-timers or weekly persons or anybody entering your premises. If you have a guard, then guard also comes out, sits with mask, washes hands and goes away. Doesn't enter the your premises. So if we keep these two, three things, I'm sure you should feel confident that there's no way you can get or your family can get infected by the virus.
जी सर. सर अभी मीडिया में और कई कई जगहों पे सोशल मीडिया में कई सारी मिथ्स हैं जो कोरोना वायरस के रिलेटेड है. एंड कॉमन वन दैट आई रेड वाज समथिंग अबाउट इट्स रिलेशन टू बीइंग एन एयरबोर्न डिजीज. सर इसमें कितनी सच्चाई है?
वेल इट इज एब्सोल्युटली इनकरेक्ट. देयर वाज वन स्टडी फ्रॉम यूएसए व्हेन दे सजेस्टेड दैट इट कुड बी एयरबोर्न. But the method, I think, you know, only the medical person will know, the methodology used was not correct. So what did they do? They put the viruses in a liquid form, you know, in a liquid suspension. And then they created an aerosol out of that. Like the asthma patients, they use the medication. There is a spray. And then they said, oh, it hangs on the, it's not correct. It's a droplet, and droplet is very big. Cannot be seen under with eyes, but I'm sure when there is a sunlight, when you are coughing, you can see the droplets coming out.
So, air mein suspended nahi reh sakta hai zyada time ke liye.
Cannot remain suspended. Yes, cannot. And also, this is one virus which may, on a surface, any surface, it can stay for couple of hours only.
जी.
Because the virus. For their survival, they have to go to other living cell
for the
to derive
host.
Their energy and their reproduction can be done only when they are with some cell
other,
which is living.
Yeah. जी sir. सर तो ये आपने बहुत अच्छा बताया क्योंकि ये भी एक पैनिक सिचुएशन क्रिएट हो रही थी कि ये एयरबोर्न है कि नहीं है. सर आपका इतनी डेकेड्स का एक्सपीरियंस रहा है, आपने बहुत ही क्लोजली ऑब्जर्व किया है, मैनेज किया है और इवन गाइडलाइंस भी एस्टैब्लिश करी फॉर ओबेसिटी की मैनेजमेंट एशिया के लिए और इंडिया के लिए. सर इस वक्त बहुत सारा एवरीवन इज अंडर एन अनप्रेसिडेंटेड अमाउंट ऑफ स्ट्रेस. देयर इज अ लॉट ऑफ स्ट्रेस दैट वी आर ऑल प्रोन टू. एंड एक बहुत ही स्ट्रॉन्ग कोरिलेशन होता है स्ट्रेस का विद ओबेसिटी. सर तो ऐसे में आप अपने पेशेंट्स को या जो आपके यू नो आपकी एडवाइस सीख करते इवन जो हमारे कम्युनिटी मेंबर्स हैं एट famhealth.in/community. सर तो उनके लिए आप क्या व्हाट आर सम इम्पोर्टेंट टिप्स जो आप इस वक्त हम सब जो ओबेसिटी से स्पेशली जो मॉर्बिड ओबेसिटी से स्ट्रगल कर रहे हैं उनके लिए क्या टिप्स देंगे?
वेल आई थिंक देखिए अभी जो सबसे इम्पोर्टेंट मैसेज मैं सबको बता रहा हूँ वो ये है कि हम सोशल डिस्टेंसिंग पे बहुत बात कर रहे हैं बट हम सोशल मीडिया डिस्टेंसिंग की बात नहीं कर रहे हैं.
जी
आई थिंक इट्स वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट दैट वी शुड you know, distance ourselves from social media.
I agree, sir. I agree.
Yeah, because that is what is creating fear. And I'm sure all of persons who are using social media must have seen rumors. 99.99% of the social media is filled with rumors. The simple thing is that you just go to the government websites and other things and you know accurately. You go to the newspapers, some authentic newspapers, reputed newspapers, they will give you exactly what is happening. And don't listen what comes to your social media. So I would say that this social distancing is really important to prevent the infection. But social distancing from social media is important for your psychological well-being, because if you get panicked and you get worried, you transmit it to your wife, husband, spouse, children, staff, family members, friends, you know, so that transmission can be stopped. So this is a very important message I would like to give. Second, what I have seen is that people start sort of getting, oh, I don't have this, I don't have that. Plus, what you should compare is that what happens when you develop the infection, you are quarantined, you are in isolation, where nothing is available. So it
You're
is
away
better.
From the family.
Yeah. So you are not with the family members. You should be very happy that you are in your own place, your own comfort level. You have air conditioning, you have internet, you have a telephone, communications, books, knowledge, YouTube, movies, Netflix, everything is available. There could be nothing better than this which can happen. And you have, in any case, you have nothing else to do also. So acceptance, I would say, is the first starting point. You accept that this is a reality of life and you are privileged that you are at home with your family members. So once you take that approach, then you don't crib. Otherwise, you know, cribbing starts that, okay, I'm not having some people. What can go wrong? If you're not having a newspaper, it doesn't make any difference at all. If you're not having a newspaper, not having a newspaper. There are many other ways to read the newspaper. Electronic newspaper is there. So I think whatever you are, please understand that you are 99.9% in a comfort zone. If anybody goes to a medical quarantine or a medical ICU, everything is lost. So that is your aim should be.
So ye bhool jate hain ki hum kitne how blessed we are. हम हर चीज को इतना फॉर ग्रांटेड हमने अपनी लाइफ में लिया है सर कि ये चीजें जो हमको इस वक्त अवेलेबल हैं वी आर प्रिविलेज्ड कि वी हैव ऑल ऑफ
दिस बट सम पीपल क्रिप कि आई एम नॉट एबल टू गो फॉर अ मॉर्निंग वॉक कम ऑन आई थिंक द मॉर्निंग वॉक
ट्रू सर
यू विल गो बट व्हाई टेक अ रिस्क ऑफ मॉर्निंग वॉक एंड नॉट ओनली गेटिंग इन्फेक्शन बट आल्सो यू आर माइट बी कैरिंग इट एंड यू मे स्प्रेड इट सो स्मॉल लिटिल थिंग्स यू शुड रिकनसाइल यू नो वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट
So, when it comes to obesity, what are the important things that we should keep in mind?
I think obesity, everybody has to understand that obesity itself reduces your immunity. Because almost 50 to 60% obese person will be diabetic or maybe pre-diabetic. So, that is another condition. Second, in obesity, your pulmonary functions are very poor. As we know that the COVID-19 is the basically respiratory virus. Your respiration, your lungs are smaller because your abdomen is big. So the space in the chest and the lungs are, you know, like pushed up. So that is one. Then many of them will have a diabetic nephropathy. That means the kidneys are damaged because of diabetes. They are more prone for infection and many of them will have a hypertension. So I think obesity is not just the kilograms on weighing scale, but it is a clinical condition which reduces your immunity overall, you know, and diabetes, chest problem, joint problems, limited movement. You may not be able to exercise as much as one considers it to be. So obesity per se is a big predisposition for the virus, because if a healthy person may not get the infection, but anybody who's compromised immunologically or otherwise, but multiple factors, and again they will also have a fatty liver. So all organs are involved: liver, kidney, heart, lungs. So I think they are much more prone. So they should be even more strict. And maybe I would say even for a longer period. So if somebody is advised quarantine for 2 weeks, they should maybe quarantine for 3 weeks or 4 weeks, because they would like to be 100% sure, because they have got their infighting resistance activity will be very poor. And if God forbid obese patients develop this, if you really look at the figures, the obesity has been one of the main criteria
risk factor.
For causing serious complications and also the mortality. Mortality, if somebody obese person develops COVID, is very high.
So I think this is a really insightful thing that you told us, because in the last couple of weeks we have been talking to doctors about how various groups are vulnerable to COVID, and most of the times the focus was either on people who have a lung problem or who have a heart problem or who have diabetes. But this important point that you pointed out, that how obesity is a complex syndrome that contains all of these conditions, so okay. all the more reasons why people with obesity will be at a higher risk, and how yeah. like diabetologists say that people who have diabetes, they should be kept separate from the rest of the family. Yeah. They should take extra precautions. So similarly, it's a fantastic point that people who are obese, they should be also considered to be a high-risk population, and extra care and precautions should be taken. So very, very insightful point there, sir. This is where experience yeah. comes in handy. Ji, yeah. Sir, Jahantak, sir, since you handle a lot of other specialties as well, so what about elective surgeries? Sir, are they best avoided right now?
Well, I think we strongly feel that elective surgery, first of all, should be avoided as far as possible. And I have some medical reason for that. First of all, I mean, somebody who has got undergoing elective surgery, he or she may not know that they are carrying asymptomatic COVID virus also. So they will have to move out of yeah. their home. They will be exposing themselves outside. They will go to the hospital. At least some family member will come. Maybe a spouse, at least the children's spouse, will have to see them before surgery, after surgery. So that unnecessarily pulls out the family members out of the safe environment of home to the hospital. So that is another point. And as I said, many of these chronic problems like gallbladder stones and the hernias and other related sort of things, most of the people are carrying for months and years, you know. So I would suggest that it is better to avoid, because we would not like them and their family to be going out of their safe home situation to exposure to the roads and places. Second thing is, all said and done, I don't really have a valid reason, but the question is very, anesthesia surgery is a little abnormal situation. I'm not too sure whether it reduces immunity or not, but still I would say that it is not a normal condition of the body. Yeah, no, yeah. It's not physiological. So it is better to be avoided. However, but if somebody has got pain in abdomen, some, you know, biliary colic or something, they should not hesitate in taking advice from their local physicians. And if not, then they can go to the casualties, because all hospitals have got their casualties and they can get a first aid management and proper diagnosis. For example, suppose a stone from the gallbladder moves into the common bile duct and patient develops pancreatitis. I would suggest that there's no point in staying at home. That's because it. Pancreatitis...
It can be
Or if the hernia gets strangulated, there's no point. So one has to go to the hospital. And in that situation, you know, like, we are also compelled to operate, and because we have no choice. So.
Yeah. Because the patient safety comes first.
Safety comes first, yes.
जी सर, सर जब सर्जरी जो इलेक्टिव सर्जरीज है, सो उसमें ऐसा भी तो होता होगा दैट देयर इज द रिस्क ऑफ कंटामिनेशन इन द हॉस्पिटल फैसिलिटी एंड द मेडिक्स एंड द पैरामेडिक्स. सो
दैट इज but that is the reason why I think, you know, we all have declared a COVID hospital. So yes. if you see the as per the protocols, some hospital which is having, you cannot partially make it a COVID hospital.
Yes.
The whole hospital and block has to be called a COVID hospital, where no elective patients, elective surgeries or other specialties should not be entertained in that.
Ji. Ji, sir. Sir, now since all of us are locked down indoors, zyada kuch karne ko nahi hai, sir. Sir, lekin agar humko apni immunity boost karni hai ya apni metabolic rate improve karni hai, jisse hamari immunity boost hogi, so uske liye kya kuch kar sakte hain?
Dekhiye, aisa hai ki ghar mein, kyunki agar aap recollect karein ki aap kisi se bhi baat karte hain ki bhai aap exercise karte hain ya kuch karte hain, so everybody will say, no, utna time nahi milta mereko, you know, I am very busy. So that excuse is gone. And that excuse I have heard from 99.9% persons who are not doing exercise.
Yeah.
And the persons who are doing exercise probably must be the busiest person who finds time for exercise. So that is not an excuse. And home, if you have even 2 feet by 2 feet space for where you are standing, there are so many things which you can do by standing. You can jump, you can skip, you can do a jogging on the same, without any this thing. Ah, so spot jogging can be done. You can have so many things which are heavy available with you, weights. You can do that. And I think that could be much more calorie burning exercises than one many of the gymnasium or walking can do. So there's no reason why you must do it, because I very much insist and I strongly feel that we give a lot of importance to sort of diet for weight loss and BMR. But what is important, it is, I don't say that you do it for hours, but about 30-40 minutes of burning calorie is very important, very vital for you to do. So a good high protein diet, the diet should be high protein, because it should be low carbohydrate diet, because it's a sedentary day and night for you. So have a high protein diet. And also the third tripod, the part of a tripod which I very strongly feel is a sleep pattern. You should have very good 7-8 hours sleep at a right time. So when I say right time, it's not that you sleep at 4 o'clock or 5 o'clock in the morning and wake up at 12 or 1 o'clock. What is a good 9, 10, 11, 12? Like you should sleep till 7-8 in the morning. It gives you a good balance. And that's why I call it a tripod: diet, physical activity, and good night, 6 to 8 hours sleep at a proper time. And that's, I think, will keep you healthy. And I'm very optimistic about things. If you are able to develop these three things during these 3-4 weeks of isolation, I'm sure that will bring up your health in any case. And also I would like to say that you should avoid, as far as possible, one should avoid high calorie food, something which increases the cholesterol. And also it's better to avoid alcohol as far as possible, because we know that alcohol is empty calorie. You cannot burn those calories. That is one. And second, alcohol is a depressant. So, in any case, you are going through anxiety and other things. It will further increase your element of depression. So many people say that, but I strongly feel, it's not that you can't touch it, I'm just saying, but it should not become your habit that every day you're sitting till midnight and drinking, thinking that it is going to...
Moderation is the key there.
Moderation is the key. Occasional... This thing is a key. And of course, as I mentioned, that avoid fatty food.
Ji sir, this must be after, I think, like you said, like once in 100 years, a situation like this has arisen in the entire world, jahan pe sari family, other than the emergency services, sari family saath mein hai. So we are hearing a lot mixed new reports. There are, while as there are cases of domestic abuse increasing, there are a lot of anxiety levels are high. So to aise mein, sir, jaise aapne rightfully kaha ki pehle to hum wait kar rahe hote hain ki हमको क्वालिटी टाइम आपस में मिले और अब मिल रहा है, वी डोंट नो व्हाट टू डू विद इट, क्योंकि अब हमको आदत ही नहीं रही है. सो तो ऐसे में जो भी फैमिली मेंबर्स आपको देख रहे हैं, या सो व्हाट इज द एडवाइस दैट यू वुड लाइक टू गिव देम?
माय सिंपल एडवाइस इज लेट एवरीबॉडी बी लेफ्ट अलोन. माय वेरी सिंपल एडवाइस, यू शुड नॉट इंटरवीन इन ईच एंड एवरीबॉडीज रूटीन. सपोज आई वुड से, बिकॉज़ दोस आर द पॉइंट्स, बिकॉज़ एवरीबॉडी इज स्ट्रेस्ड.
First of all, become irritants.
Is irritant. So suppose you want to see a movie, you can see a movie. I mean, you should not say that, oh, this is your second movie or third movie which you are seeing.
Hmm.
And I'm not giving a very vague example. If you want to read a novel, you should read a novel. You should read a book. You should look at YouTube. You can look at knowledge-based informative things which you have not been able to do. You may relook at your investments, where all the investments are. You may sort of create an album of your photographs.
Yes, there are many people who are learning cooking now who have never done this before.
Yes.
So, yeah.
First of all, I think you should take away from your mind, first of all, there's so many things all of us we want to do, if you wanted to do. So what happens that if you look at your old photographs where maybe you find yourself, you're painting something, or you know, some ladies knitting the sweater. You can do it. I mean, what prevents
exactly.
you? So
now
I think looking at, and I'll look at all happy photos in the past. And this is the best time to understand each and every member of the family, what they want. Interaction should be open. Interaction should be absolutely positive, and no negativity should be there. And I would say that just leave them alone. Somebody wants to have bath at 10 o'clock, let him have bath at 10 o'clock.
Mothers generally tend to be extremely,
I am
also a mother, so I can imagine.
Yeah. So I think, you know, just leave them alone, because it's very difficult to control for a very long period.
Yeah. So jo hamara controlling nature hota as the head of the family, shayad usko thoda let go karna padega.
Because that nature comes in a short period. Now, when you come from office or the workplace, and you have got just 1 or 2 hours, and then you have to make the homework also done, and then prepare for the next day's dress, and prepare for food and this and that. So those things are spread out now. It should be a good situation. If you don't want to have a breakfast, don't have a breakfast. You want to have a brunch at 12 o'clock, it doesn't matter. You know, how does it matter? But that you say that, okay, you were going to office, so you were having breakfast at 8. It doesn't matter. You don't want to have it at 8. You can have it at 10, 12, 11, whenever you feel comfortable with.
So I think, sir, the takeaway message from this is flexibility is the key, isn't it? Yes. We have to be very, very flexible.
Yeah. Don't be pokey on your spouses or your children's sort of thing. I'm sure everybody is mature, and something which is absolutely wrong, then it's fine. But I think this should be possibly, I would say that this is a time when you should have the less fights. Because everybody is relaxed, there's no... So
the opposite
you have to make a conscious effort.
Yeah, you have to make a... And sir, like you said, I think these are words of wisdom, that flexibility is very necessary. I think we have to let people who are around us also be. Because everyone processes...
Own.
Yeah, because everyone processes stress in their own ways.
Yeah.
And unless and until the health is not harmed, then we should just leave our loved ones to fetch for themselves. I think this has been a fantastic session that we have today. A little, mujhe lagta more into the social aspect of COVID. And I think these are really words of wisdom jo aapne aaj sir humare saath share kiye.
Thank you
so much for taking out the time and talking to us. And if anyone has any question related to obesity, all gallstones, all hernia, because sir is an expert, you can write to us at farmhealth.in/community or in questions ko hum sir tak lekar jayenge, and jaise sir ke paas time hoga unse hum wo reply bhi aap tak lekar aayenge. So take care of yourself, stay indoors, stay safe. Thanks a lot, sir.
Thank you, Dr. This is always a pleasure. Thank you.